All right. Welcome, everybody, to the Collective Creativity Workshop, the IGDA Leadership Summit. We've been searching for the appropriate acronym, IGDALSCCW. And at the end of this, you can all write that on your resumes and LinkedIns. Because you're going to be creating, together, solutions and inspirations and ideas to address the issues that we all got to see today from the Developer Satisfaction Survey. This is your chance to contribute. Megan and Anne will be joining me today. We'll be having an interactive session with all of you where we're going to be addressing top issues and solving them together. Why? Because this industry is in need of positive change. If you were here yesterday and heard Megan and Dean and Dan talk at the panel, it was clear, even asking the audience, that things need a boost in this industry. Creativity suffers, diversity suffers, representation suffers. We're in need of positive change. In this room, there are people with deep experience. You've worked for studios, you've worked for yourselves, you've worked for platforms, large companies, small companies, you've advised studios, you've been everywhere all at once. That's the magic of being a group. So this room is full of experience. And this is the place where we can let that experience come out to play. Ideas, inspirations, innovation. It sounds chaotic, and there will be some chaos, but this is the right place to be. And it's better to come up with ideas together than it is to have just a bunch of people yelling at you what their ideas are, what they should be. This is not an industry that we're going to let be dictated from on high. We own this industry. We're a part of this industry. We come up with solutions. That's why we're really glad to have you here today. So, here's the format. It's an interactive workshop. You're working in teams. Say hi to your teams. That's your team. In these teams, you're going to use your own experiences and ideas to come up with solutions to a series of issues that we have worked with IGDA leadership to prioritize. We'll be putting them up on the board, 10 minutes per issue. You're going to be using the papers and post-it notes and, what's the word I want to say? I don't want to say fermenting the ideas because we're not exactly brewing beer here, but it's a collaborative effort and a collaborative environment where the best ideas rise to the top. The goal is to inspire improvements. We're going to show you the places that your feedback from the survey indicates need to be improved, and you'll be working to come up with some ideas how to improve them. We don't need to hear more problems. We want to hear your improvements and solutions. This is a creative exercise. Now, you're creating the solutions. As you create them, you'll bring them up to the board, and after this session, Anne will be creating a roadmap from all these ideas that you've brought forward. It's a framework that will allow us to have continued conversations wherever we go. Back to our companies, other leadership summits, GDC. This is something that you can take with you. You'll also be making new connections. Maybe you don't know everybody around your table. I hope you get a chance to chat with folks. This is how we get things done. And collective intelligence for positive change. I don't know why I put that there. I think it means something. It's really important. Just don't forget that part. So again, after the session, Anne will be creating an infographic. That'll come out to you, and you'll get a chance to take that out and continue to work on positive change.
We'll send that to you in email after
she's done. But first.
So we're going to just do a little quick exercise, and some of you might have been here yesterday when we did it, just to warm everybody up. So everybody just please stand up and pick your partner next to you. And one of you will be A, and one of you will be B.
And
okay? All right, and A's? No, just A's and B's for now. So, oh, does everyone have a partner?
No.
Okay, how about you two join up?
And
Hey, actually, we're only doing this exercise once, and the rest of it will be a group, so if we can figure this out just for now, I think we'll be okay.
We can have one group.
I can come and do this.
I'll be a partner. I'll be a partner.
Who needs
a partner?
I'll come with you.
Okay. All right, does everybody have a partner? Okay, you're good. Okay. All right, so here we go. A, your job is to tell B something you care about. It could be a great idea. It could be your wife, your baby, something you're really passionate about. And B, your job is to ignore and dismiss A with every part of your body and words. We're going to do this for a minute. So go. Tell me when it's enough time. Okay, all right. Thank you. That was really good dismissing and avoiding. That was awesome. So now we're going to change roles. And B, your job is to tell A what you care about, what you're really passionate about. And A, your job is to criticize B in your words and in your actions. We'll do this for a minute. Okay, go. Well, you know, we could redo the exercise. Is that enough time, do you think? Okay, all right. Thank you. That was really good criticism. Awesome. Very good. Nice job.
Has anybody walked out yet?
Yeah. Well, no, one time we did this, and when we were supposed to ignore, somebody just walked out the door. But anyway, okay, so now change roles again, and A, retell B what you really care about, and B, your job is to be fully present and to listen with every bone in your body and to respond to what they're saying. Okay, let's go. Do you like it?
Yeah.
The people? Yeah, it gets people in the mood where they're fully present. That's enough time now. Okay, everybody, thank you. And now let's switch roles one more time. And B, tell A what you're excited about. And A, you listen, you give them, you be fully present with them. Okay, go. I told a lot of people about you, and they were like, wow, like they've never heard of what you've done. Yeah. No. I'm putting up my website, and I was thinking of having you a part of my services. Okay. I think that's enough time. Yeah. Okay, thank you. Okay, wrapping up. Thanks so much. And you can continue this after the session. Okay, so thank you. Everybody sit down. We can get started. You know, it's funny. When I first did that exercise, I remembered how many times I was dismissed and ignored and criticized. But it was funny. I had forgotten how many times I'd done it myself. And so it's just this great experience of unconscious bias because we all suffer from it. So with that, we're going to start getting into the workshop.
Oh yeah, we're going to get going real quick here. So we've talked about most of this already, but let's recap real quick. When we say go, for 10 minutes, you'll explore the issue that we put up on the board, bring up as many improvements and ideas as you can. Have one person be writing and put everything down on paper as much as you can. No dismissing ideas, please. Add, help, don't shut anybody down. Now, if you've got a great idea as a table, that's the one that gets everybody excited, that's a winner, get that on a post-it. Get it to the right number, you know, and it's not a quiz. We'll tell you what number it is. We're starting with one. Right on there, put it up there, and watch for us. We're going to come around. We're going to ask you how things are going. We're going to ask you to share ideas in progress, but if you've got winners, get them on the board, because that's the stuff that's going to go into the infographic. And again, contribute to wall. Markers, if you need to connect ideas or draw something, you can do that as well. We love that. Add and improve. Pick as a team. All right? So this is going to be a little chaotic, but we're going to get started. We have 10 minutes to start on the first issue. And the first issue is related to diversity in games and teams. You saw it in the DSS. Diversity not just in teams and not just in games. Both. There's an issue there. We need to explore what it is, and we need to find solutions to make sure that more diverse, more representative groups get in games and in game studios. We'll come back to the other issues after 10 minutes is up. Issue 1, diversity in games and teams. Time starts now. Please, begin. Right. All right. Good. Folks are talking. I see a lot of nodding at this table. Tell me what you got so far.
So I was talking about the fact that with diverse and visible leadership, externally visible leadership that's very diverse, it makes it a lot easier for people to see the company and say, hey, I could work here because there's someone like me there.
Be diverse, be loud about it. Be loud, be proud. That's great. And as you think about these post-its, think about calls to action. Make sure it's snappy, get it rocking. I love it, thank you.
Thank you.
do you think we shouldn't actually have them talk? Do you think we shouldn't? Do you think we should just leave them?
Yeah. I mean, I'm going up and eavesdropping and then taking it and giving it to her.
Okay.
I think that's good because I think we're distracting them if we just kind of interrupt them. You know what I mean?
Yeah, yeah.
You do it if you want.
I'll feel it out. I mean, certainly we'll, I think we want to maybe give them little hints here and there, like, you know, as you're thinking about it, think about calls to action, things like that.
You do that. You're better at that.
I can, yeah, okay.
People want, there's a balance we have to find. People want games with good stories, but they don't want games that are entirely similar. They want to still have, they still want some characters. So,
what games are we going to
do? Yeah.
I know it's hard to believe, but we're halfway through the first 10 minutes. Get you some post-its here pretty soon. People are doing a lot of acquiring. Now they have to do the other thing. As we cross into 3 minutes left, begin to shift your thinking from acquiring to developing the post-its that you really want to put up there. We will want to see some post-its, so. To the posters that you came up with, so they don't have to do it in the middle of this.
Yeah. I don't think they're writing yet.
Well, I'm going to try to encourage them to do that.
Okay.
And we'll see what happens.
But if not, we have, I mean, they seem to be engaged, and
yeah,
they're writing it all on one piece of paper, so we can take all that intelligence.
Well, yeah, we're going to get it one way or the other.
Okay. You need another?
We're down to 2 minutes left. With 1 minute to go, we're hearing a lot of great conversations. And that's 10 minutes. That's 10 minutes. Time to wrap up that conversation. Now, thank you. Thank you. You've made it through the first one. Give yourselves a hand, please. Now, we've been listening to your conversations. We have been writing things up on the board. We have gathered some data. You have much more on your pieces of paper. That one is completely full. That's incredible. And we will be collecting it and using all of it. If you have calls to action that are really crisp and you want them on the board, write them on a post-it and get them up here. Otherwise, we will do some work to get that into the infographic later. But as we go, don't be shy. If you've got a call to action and you want it up there, run right up there and take care of it. We've got more issues to go, but we got to get going. So moving on to issue number two. All right, issue number two, coming right up. All right, issue number two, and we really want your feedback on this one too. We're gonna want you to turn your eyes to the board. Number two, we heard about crunch, you know it, you hate it, but the industry seems to love it. What's the problem? Work-life balance and compensation. That's a big topic, but I think we've all felt it before. Are you ready? Time starts now. Union, yeah. Ding, ding, ding. I heard unionize already. That's bingo. IGDA bingo.
bunch of this, like, that public shaming, in my opinion.
There can even be, like, an accreditation or something.
Yeah, yeah. IGDA approved studio.
Right. Public. Public code of ethics, I hear. I hear public best practices and code of ethics. Very good. I like that.
Privacy, social media privacy policy.
Yeah, I've got one for you when you're ready. Public, it's like public best practices code of ethics. Shaming, but it's kind of what they mean.
Yeah.
You know, if you're with it, if you're not, you're called out, that kind of thing. Time flies. We have 4.5 minutes left. I hear that a lot, so it's okay. You're saying you won't put it on a post-it note and put it up there? All right, it's my fault. Wherever you want that. Minute and a half to go, 90 seconds. We can put post-its on the board for you. Raise your hand, we will bring it to the board for you. All right, less than a minute to go. Any calls to action you want us to bring up to the board, throw them on a post-it. Raise your hand, we'll bring them to the board for you. Oh, thank you. Wonderful. Wonderful, wonderful. Thank you for that. All right. Great job, everybody. We've seen some more post-its on this one. Time is up on this issue. We're moving on to the next one. All right. Wrap up your conversations, and we're moving on. I love the passion. I've also gotten a lot of complaints about my time limits. Trust me, I hear you. I hear you. I am sorry. I am sorry for my time limits. It is my fault. It is my fault. Please wrap up. Please wrap. We know some of you have to go at 3:15. I want to get through one more issue at least with you all. It's 3:05 now. 10 minutes, we can have another issue wrapped up. Are you ready? Okay. Career placement advancement security. By that I mean, it's a gig economy. You jump from studio to studio. Turns out the developer satisfaction survey shows most of us don't want that. Most of us want to grow in place, be with the team that trusts us, that we love, that loves them. Why the disconnect? What can we do about it? Career advancement, placement security. Time starts now. Someone's going to say unionize again. Yeah, unionize! Bingo!
Yeah.
All right, about 5 minutes left. All right, 3 minutes left for this issue.
Trying to jump ahead. Don't look at that one. Don't look at that one. It's, I'll get you. I'll get you.
All right, 2 minutes to go on this issue. I'm seeing teams bringing up Post-its. Thank you so much for that. It's great. Keep them coming.
Conversations are excellent.
Down to your final minute. 1 minute left.
What'd you say?
And then you raise your hand and I'll take it. Yes, I got it. Thank you, yes. And this one's for number three, yeah? Okay. Moral rights, IGDA standard practices. All right. All right. That's time on issue number three. That's time on issue number three. No one's even listening to me. I love it. All right. No, it's great. No, it's great. These conversations are great. I am evil. I am the time god. All right. It is now 3:15. If you must be at another session, you may go. Thank you for your contributions. We are here until 3:45, and we have other issues to cover. So stay if you've got more to do. I think things are going very well. And if you need to leave for 3:15 sessions, now's the time. It's coming right up. The next one's coming right up. The next one is about the future generations, the entry-level job prospects. College graduates are finding it very hard to find jobs. The Developer Satisfaction Survey makes that painfully clear. What can we do to make sure that the next generation of game developers has the opportunity to get in and really make a change? How do we help them get into the industry? Time starts now. It was a pleasure to have you. Thanks so much.
Yeah, okay.
Thanks so much for coming. Thank you. Hey, how's it going? Sure, yeah. You bet. We got some folks that left to another session, but we have two tables still working on our fourth issue. Take a look at the board. We've got a lot of great solutions, a lot of great ideas.
Studios are disproportionately having to spend a lot where, you know, Microsoft or somebody could
looking at infographics that like in Argentina.
So I've got one. I got one that looks pretty good for number four.
Okay.
It's incubators. Incubators to grow. Incubators to grow and ship non-AAA games. So they can ship, they don't have to ship AAA. That's a good, well, that was that table. I'm just listening in and I'm bringing them to the board. The most important thing I did when I was at DigiPen getting my two-year degree was the game projects, because I learned how to ship. You have to ship games, you have to finish them. Always ship, 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 ship. All right, about 5 minutes left. Somebody tossed me a post-it note. 5 minutes left, and check my email, but
yeah,
I think you're right.
We definitely did.
Well, there might be room for one more there.
Yeah, she's gonna put one right.
Okay. Three minutes left on this issue. 3 minutes to go. Board's looking a little light. Little light. Apprenticeship program. Why not? Why not? IGDA licensed apprenticeships.
I'm actually here when I'm working.
Why?
had an apprenticeship program because they were diversified, they could get federal tax credits for it, that would give you guys the leverage to then say, instead of some type of guild or some type of unionized program, we should become IGDA certified because the federal government will give us tax incentives because we are doing X, Y, and Z, apprenticeship programs and that type of thing, diversification. That would be your only, that could be
that
teeth to enforce something.
That could work. It's a carrot. It's better than a stick.
Yeah.
Let's see. One thing that Seth was talking about, I think he said for number three, is pursue tax credits for diversity hiring.
All right. That's 10 minutes on issue number 4. If anybody has post-its to shoot up there, please do. We heard a lot of similar notes between number 3 and 4, so we'll probably work to merge those. We have a bonus 5th topic that I want us to tackle. There's still a little bit of time, so let's give 10 minutes to a very important topic. Let's hear it for our special guest. Ending discrimination in this industry of all kinds. Ending discrimination of all kinds in this industry. There shouldn't be any. Let's take 10 minutes, really bring it home, and let's end discrimination in this industry. Time starts now.
I think we can do the loop now. Yeah. No. That's totally fine, by the way. That's
Well, it kind of goes together. Like, we could have
it's a low, this is the earliest rung of this.
Like, we could have this title as part of career placement.
I totally agree. No, that's great. That's great. I think they're starting to stop fucking with their game. Oh man. I think it's valid. I think it stays on the board. I think it's stop fucking with developers.
A lot of
All right. We're wrapping it up in 4 minutes. If you got anything to add, this is the time. It doesn't have to just be about number five. If you want to search back, give us more action items, there's room on this board. If you got anything left, now it is the time. Crappy Joe. Three minutes and we're wrapping it up.
I've really enjoyed this. I think it's about 3:35, so there's a networking break until 3:45, so that will be the opportunity, and we'll just say, hey, be sure to introduce yourself to your teammates. The thing I really want to do is the only way this is going to continue is if they fund.
If you keep the conversation going.
That's right, and the people who are in this room are now invested. They're the most powerful force walking out of this room, as long as they stay together.
As long as they stay together and take these back to their companies.
So,
right?
I think it's good to just encourage networking.
That's good.
You know,
that's awesome.
Please keep the conversation going.
Yeah,
is that cool?
Oh, yeah, that's cool.
All right.
That's good.
And we'll finish with that.
Yeah, I think it was really good.
Oh, I think
very engaged. You know.
Yeah, everybody was very, yeah.
And that's time, everybody. That is the end of our workshop today. Now, I hear the conversations continuing, and you're on the right track. It's 3:35. Next session start in 10 minutes. So before we wrap up, I want to make sure everybody hears this. I want to make sure everybody hears this. And then you can continue your conversation. I'm even going to make the screen blank so you can only see me. All right. What you have on the board, what you've created, is incredibly important. What's even more important is the fact that you are now together and you are invested in what you have created. This can't be the end of the conversation. What we're going to help create, what Anne will be delivering to you, the results of your creation, is the beginning of a commitment to taking what you've created and acting on it, bringing it to your workplaces, your organizations, and continuing this fight. Because it is. It is a struggle. You, together, are the most powerful force walking out of this room. I want to make sure you take the next 5 to 10 minutes, exchange emails, make sure you get those bonds nice and tight. Because what you've done doesn't stop here. Network, make sure you trade emails, phone numbers, whatever you need. Because you're the ones that are going to go out here with what we've created and take the message forward. We're stronger together. Thank you so much for creating with us today. This has been a huge pleasure. Thank you from Megan, Anne, from me. It's been great having you here. Thank you so much. Give yourselves a hand, please. Ha ha. I'm so excited. I nearly fell over. Thank you. Enjoy the rest of the conference.